Before studying at the University of Groningen, you should know that the Dutch educational system can be different from the one in your home country, in terms of the grading system, the contacts with teachers, and the way of working.
For me, it's challenging, really challenging. The education system in Netherlands is more tough.
The biggest problem I had with the studies, like differences, is that in Mexico our studies are practical views, so everything is practical in the real life, and here everything is just theoretical.
You have to be more analytic and connecting the ideas in the book.
So for me it was a really big problem to read books and read and everything like suppositions and never really practical as I use, and I think it's better, but different systems.
So it's analytic and more evaluative.
Yeah, I study a lot because the school is not that easy.
The grading system in the Netherlands is probably different from the system in your home country. The Dutch grading scale runs from the highest mark, 10, to lowest mark, 1. Grades 9 and 10 are rarely awarded, so don't be disappointed if you score a 7 or an 8. These are good scores in the Dutch system.
A 6, which is kind of just like a pass, is acceptable by students that, and maybe like people want to get a 6 or a 7, whereas I guess in Canada people really, they want to get an, well, I guess which would be an 8 or a 9, like an a B plus or an A, and it's really important to get high grades in Canada, I think.
We can get, we are from 0 to 100, and for us it's not that hard, like here you will never have a 9 maybe, but we can have hundreds.
If you want to get a 10, you won't be able to, well, what I've experienced, you won't be able to in the system. So by coming here, you should know that you can still get good grades.
Here they face, they put a lot of attention in the procedures. For us, no, it's just to get the result because it's what you want.
The Dutch education system values your independence and encourages you to take responsibility for yourself. As a student, you're expected to plan your own study schedule by attending lectures, planning your own assignments, working independently with little or no supervision, and sometimes also in a group situation.
Everything can be managed if we are aware and focused.
Teachers expect you to do a lot of work by yourself. You have to find out a lot. I think that's the biggest difference.
Sometimes, before the D-Day that I have to submit my assignment, I still haven't come up with the idea how to make it.
They give you feedback, but you have to build a lot of skills by yourself.
I have to focus and work really hard.
Besides the ability to work independently, the Dutch educational system also values the ability to work in a team. Students often have to work together on an assignment. In those cases, the individual members of the group all get the same grade.
But in Poland, I think it's not so popular to work in groups. When I came here, and I was really afraid, what is it going to be about working with groups, working with Dutch people, working with different people from Indonesia and African countries?
Mexicans are famous because we are really unpunctual, but in my education and my school, they teach me from really small that I have to be punctual, so I really have no problem with the punctuality.
Some projects which you have to actually do in your group, so you have still like 3 people more to help you, so it's quite easier now.
The interaction with your teachers may take some getting used to. Contacts with teachers tend to be informal. Some teachers prefer to be called by their first names. And they sometimes play the role of coach rather than the role of the traditional teacher. You have to develop and express your own opinion and your own approach. An active and assertive attitude during lectures is highly valued.
It's more relaxed and more comfy here. Because you can go to your teacher like every time you see him, every time you pass the corridor and you see him, you can always go and ask, sorry, man.
The professors here are like, they are dressed like us. And in Mexico, the professors are really well dressed.
In Indonesia, it's more formal.
I think maybe I found it a little bit more relaxed.
And here you need to make dates with them. No, not the appointments.
I don't speak to them like, hey, Miss, hey, Thomas, or hey, Herjan. No, not by name. So that's kind of similar in Poland.
And they never put you more time as they have it, like in the rules they have. If they said you have one course, 1 hour, it's just 1 hour, but they won't take give you more time.
It's also more easy to get contact with him. In Poland, it's really like more formal way.
And you can email them and they'll email you right back, and you can just stop in their office and ask questions, and they're very open if you have any questions, and they're happy to answer anything, any problems you have. Yep.
The Handbook for International Students will give you more information on Groningen, its university, the educational system, Dutch culture, and all kinds of practical issues. You will receive it when you arrive in Groningen. And there's more information on the university's website, www.rug.nl.